Good Friday morning from NASA's Johnson Space Center. This is Mission Control Houston. You're looking at the International Space Station flight control room from the front left of the room, looking across the consoles of flight controllers that are overseeing all of the systems on board the International Space Station. The team has been on console since about 7 o'clock this morning, Friday morning Central Time, and today, once again, as with the entire week, has been led by Flight Director Royce Renfrew, who you see standing there. He is the flight director for this shift all week. He's joined to his right by Hal Getzelman, who's serving as the spacecraft communicator, the communications link between the flight control team and the crew on board the International Space Station. The ISS is currently tracking southeasterly toward the coast of Mauritania, having made a pass across the North Atlantic and now headed down across portions of Africa before moving into an orbital sunset in about 30 minutes or so. From this vantage point of 240 miles above the Earth, the station is circling the Earth every hour and a half or so, offering an orbital sunrise and sunset every orbit, every 45 minutes as the station circles around the globe, with the crew members on board serving as the Expedition 30 crew, continuing in their Friday, which began about 1 o'clock in the morning. That crew consists of Commander Dan Burbank, who is a U.S. astronaut that launched with two Russian colleagues, Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin, back in November of 2011. Those three crew members are slated to return home at the end of April. The other three crew members on board joining them are Oleg Kononenko, Andre Kuipers, who is from the Netherlands, and U.S. astronaut Don Pettit. They launched and joined the other three crew members in late December, and they're scheduled to return home in early July. The first three crew members enjoying their 125th day in space today, 123 of those aboard the International Space Station. The quote, youngest three of the six, Kononenko, Kuipers, and Pettit, are in their 87th day in space, 85 of those aboard the International Space Station. Burbank, Friday, has spent almost exclusively his time working with cable routing associated with the high-rate communications system. This procedure routes KU communications to a joint station local area network and a secondary KU communications unit avionics power cable, along with two multiplexer demultiplexer cables on board as well. These are located behind one of the avionics racks in the Destiny lab, requiring the rack to be rotated forward for access. Pettit spent more time with investigations into how flames are controlled. He did most of that on Thursday, wrapping up all of that activity, which helps investigators on the ground lead to improvements in technologies aimed at reducing pollution emissions while also improving burning efficiency for a wide variety of industries. Kuipers has been working on stowage in and around the Leonardo Permanent Multipurpose Module. He's also used the onboard ham radio equipment to make contact with middle school students in Belgium. The Russian crew members conducted research and housekeeping chores that included work in the Zvezda service module on its ventilation system cleaning. They've been collecting periodic routine air samples as well, and they've also conducted some Earth observation as part of their timeline, which is part of an experiment to record color bloom patterns in the waters of the central eastern Atlantic. This weekend, the crew will essentially be off duty, but will conduct routine housekeeping chores, exercise. They'll check some autonomous payloads on board to ensure they're operating properly, and they'll also have time to talk and visit with their family and friends back here on Earth. While all of that's going on orbit, down here on the ground, preparations for launch of the third automated transfer vehicle are continuing down in South America at the Ariane Space Facility in Kourou. The Eduardo Amaldi, as it's named, currently is set for launch next Thursday, Thursday night Central Time, pending completion of the ongoing launch readiness review, which should wrap up Friday. The launch at 11:34 p.m. Central Time, March 22nd, leads to rendezvous and docking with the station at 5:34 p.m. Central Time, Wednesday, March 28th, delivering supplies and logistics to the station's Expedition 30 crew. So that's all the activities that are ongoing, and that'll keep the crew busy throughout the rest of Friday as the team of flight controllers around the world watch over the crew throughout the day. It's been a very busy week aboard the ISS for the six-member crew. The crew members spread throughout the 13,000 cubic foot facility, conducting science investigations, housekeeping chores, internal robotic ops, and Earth observations. The following last week's robotic refueling mission work by the station's Dexter robot on the end of the robotic arm outside. Internal, the seventh crew member of the station, Robonaut 2, demonstrated its own dexterity by signing "Hello World" to the Earth below. R2 also proved useful later in the week in grasping an instrument used periodically to measure air ventilation within the Destiny laboratory. It was the first time R2 conducted a task that wasn't considered a checkout item. R2 will rest for a while as ground engineers plan his next moves on orbit aboard the station. Quite a bit of Don Pettit's week was devoted to the flame experiment on board, investigating the nature of flames in microgravity and how they progress as experimenters can evaluate that data for development of systems on the ground. Andre Kuipers was busy this week with cardiovascular equipment on board, an experiment that develops countermeasures to help crew maintain their health on board. He also worked with the fluid physics experiment facility on the station. The Russian crew members also worked with experiments and investigations on board the station, as well as Earth observations, and also some work with the communication systems in one of the Russian segment modules. Commander Dan Burbank also worked with the U.S. spacesuits this week, checking them out to make sure they're in good working order in the event a spacewalk is needed on board. There are no plans for an EVA or extravehicular activity until Expedition 32 and 33 later in the year. Midweek, Burbank and Pettit, flanked by their seventh crew member, Robonaut, talked about their mission with Fox News Channel's America's Newsroom, and they also have some additional media interviews scheduled next week ahead of the automated transfer vehicle launch. So it's been a busy week in space with teams around the world assisting the crew from here on the ground. This weekend, the crew will essentially be off duty, but will conduct some routine chores on board, exercise, check some payloads, and also talk with their friends and family. We'll be back again next week with another week of coverage of Expedition 30's voyage aboard the International Space Station. Have a great weekend, everybody. This is Mission Control, Houston.